That was the kind of organization that started in 1965, actually, with Front for Rapid Economic Advancement of India. And in 1968, a smaller group had started in San Francisco with the name Indians for Collective Action. And they had applied for a non-profit, and the two groups got together, and so it became ICA, Indians for Collective Action. If you look at what's the central theme, is one is to help the people who need the help most. Second is innovation. Look at some innovative methods, ideas, technologies that are going to help transform the world. So it's about transformation.
ICA sort of distinguishes itself among all the other Indian nonprofits. It finds the right project, the right people, and the right catalyst.
Meet with people and say, okay, what is your passion? And the key here is follow your passion. Whether people in India or people over here, we say, what are you passionate about?
Alim India is a project based in India for the local Indian people there who are suffering from incurable cancer, and especially the needy and the poor who are most affected. I was very impressed that ICA was open to the idea of accepting Alim India because it was such a new field. But they heard us, they heard Dr. Rajagopal, they understood the issue, they met with him, they did due diligence to find out more about the project, and it was only after a very deliberate process that they said, we welcome Alim India.
My first major journey was through ICA. I spent a lot of time in India working in the state of Gujarat, especially in a rural part of Gujarat where a lot of tribals live. Especially very privileged to working with an organization called SEWA Rural, which is from Jhagadia. This is a wonderful healthcare delivery organization where they were spending a lot of time providing healthcare services to people who are rural, especially in tribal area altogether.
It's a critical time in India. We decided that we would start this women's leadership project focusing on women who are there at the grassroots level, who have no education, no skills, no sustainability. So basically we are looking at three aspects in our training. One is life skills, the other is livelihood, and the third one is leadership. And most often it's a combination of the three. They're focusing on women's empowerment, could alleviate poverty, could increase education, could increase production. And that's what I feel that India needs to focus on. Even if you're in high tech, you can use all of those qualities and those innovative qualities in Silicon Valley. You can translate that into social causes.
In 2018, SEWA completes almost 45 years of organizing. So today we also are recognized as a national union, India's single largest women's organization. We also work in the neighboring countries of Afghanistan, Pakistan, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Bhutan, and Myanmar. I'm very thrilled, and it is also a great honor and privilege to share our SEWA's partnership with Indians for Collective Action. Today, SEWA has over 1.8 million members, and therefore SEWA has now grown into a movement, a labor movement, a cooperative movement, a women's movement. ICA also supported us in how do we build a digital platform for SEWA's membership.
In 1994-95, Prabhu Goyal came to us and said, I want to start a project where anybody who's bright, who cannot afford education, we will provide the funds. So Foundation for Excellence started as a result of that for about a year, year and a half as part of Info Collective Action, and it has just taken off and become one of the largest private scholarship donors in India.
I came to know about ICA in the last 2 years, and I was fascinated and happy to see that people away from home were, you know, bound together by a common concern for issues in the home country. So the story of SECMOL started when I was doing my engineering. To finance my engineering, I had to teach 10th grade students in Ladakh. I saw that 95% of the students were failing every year in their 10th grade. So that's when I decided to work on education. We started working with students who still failed. So we opened a special school where those who failed would be admitted. For this alternative university, ICA has been very supportive with the generosity of various members.
In 91, two Berkeley graduate students came to me. One was Sandeep Pandey, another Deepak Gupta. And they said they want to do something for elementary school education in India. So I said, let's work together. I think it's a great idea. I said, we will involve people over here, we'll raise funds. At the same time, we'll try to see how we can help improve elementary school education in India. So we started ASHA for Education within Indians for Collective Action, and it's just doing fabulously well. So one focus we have is environment. I think it's a very big thing. The long-term health of our planet depends much on the environment, and we need to educate people, we need to help them.
Well, Ladakh is a mountain desert, high altitude desert, so water has always been a problem. The only reason people survive is thanks to the glaciers which melt. So our idea was to refreeze this winter water and keep them as ice mountains. We tried a pilot which was 7 stories tall and contained 1 million liters of water, and this lasted till early July. So there now, winter water was staying till May and June.
We are at a point where we need to decide what ICA should be in the next 50 years. Two things have to happen. ICA has to become the platform of choice for people who want to donate money and work for a cause. I want us to vet at least 10 non-profit organizations. So when we present our platform to a potential donor, we present to them the various features and benefits of each, what we are offering in each of those NGOs. And then you pick, you decide where you want to invest your money. It's time that people of the next generation feel a certain involvement, and that can come out of us engaging with local projects as well. Get ICA involved in projects that are US based.
ICA is a home for youth.
200 million people in India, less than $2 a day. Okay, and those are the numbers that, you know, the younger people should relate to.
When we give, we receive. When we go out to work for others, it changes us.
The people who work for ICA are very giving, and they don't have an agenda of their own. They're really there to contribute, to make an effort in people's lives, and they're not looking for anything.